Swami Ramakrishna Paramhansa was one of the greatest saints of India. He was the guru of Swami Vivekananda, who has popularized Hinduism and the culture of India all over the world. However, unlike Swami Vivekananda, he was not well read, but his knowledge evolved from within and from the society, from the people. One of the greatest quality of Ramakrishna Paramhansa was that he was able to make even the most complex concept very simple. We know that Bhagavad Gita is one of the most complex philosophy of the world. There are thousands of commentaries written on Bhagavad Gita. However, everybody views and understands Bhagavad Gita in a different manner. However, Swami Paramhansa has given a magic formula and simplified Bhagavad Gita in such a way that even a layman can understand it very easily. He said, if we repeat Gita, 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 then it becomes Tagi. And Tagi means, Tyagi means renunciation. In order to understand this message of Swami Paramhansa, we have to understand the meaning of renunciation. Friends, whenever we do something, whenever we do any karma, there is always a purpose behind it. For example, when we study, it is to get good marks. When we work hard in our job, it is to get better salary, better promotion. If we are doing a lot of social service, it is to get name and fame. Now, Swami Paramhansa does not say that you should renounce the karma or action. Instead of that, the message of Gita is to renounce the result or the fruit of action. Some people feel that if we don't bother about the fruit, are we going to get the fruit? This is the greatest misunderstanding. Let us understand that if you are working sincerely and studying day after day for years altogether, you are bound to get good results. If you are working sincerely and honestly at your workplace, the employer is going to notice your work and he is going to reward you. In the same way, if you are really doing good thing for the society, for the people, the world is going to take notice of that and going to give you fame, name, award, decoration. Only message of Gita is that at the time of doing the action, you should not be concerned about the fruit of action, because God or the nature or the divinity is going to give you what you truly desire. So friends, the central message of Gita is Tyagi. Tyag, that means if we can renounce the fruit of action without renouncing the karma or action, we can achieve salvation, we can achieve mukti, and we can achieve the greatest joy in our life.